You cannot smoke weed and think you're going to get to the kingdom of heaven. You're defiling your temple according to the Bible.
But your response would be, you can't tell me nothing, Dad, because you do things wrong too. Would that be wisdom? No, it's not wisdom, bro.
A sinful man will not be reproved.
A sinful man will not be reproved.
Let's do it. This is how you YCAZ. Hey, this is how you YCAZ. Hey, keeping the faith in the kingdom. And the patience will give us
those
freedom.
What else? What else you got that you can change about yourself to keep these and to put yourself in line with these laws? I got you, but we're keeping it basic right now.
All those are
we are here to go over basic things with our people. I got you. Question. Another question. You smoke? You smoke. Okay. That's something you gotta change, man. You can't smoke weed, bro. You can't smoke weed. Give me that in
Can you? Yes.
Yes.
If you use it for its medicinal purposes and not for the purpose of intoxication, in its natural form and state, unaltered.
I got you. Okay, I'm gonna show you something. Read this real quick, because we're gonna read the scripture. Read.
This is the book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 3, and verse 16.
Bring it out.
Know ye not that ye are the temple of God?
You are the temple of God, right? So with that being said, smoking weed, eating weed, the scripture's gonna show you. I got you. I'm gonna show you that. I got you. Okay, I'm gonna show you that. Read on.
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you. If any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy.
If any man, cigarettes, weed, chewing tobacco, is defiling your temple, right? Give me, I'm gonna get there. Give me Genesis 2. I'm gonna show you. Oh, yeah, give me, yeah, you know it all, Genesis 1. I'm gonna show you that. I'm gonna show you something. Read what you got.
This is the book of Genesis, chapter 1 and verse 29. And God said, behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed, which is upon the face of the earth, and every tree in the which is the fruit of the tree yielding seed, to you it shall be for meat.
So he says, he gave us fruit, vegetables, things like that. We can eat those things. That's what they're for, right? How does weed help you, bro? What's that?
It's used as marijuana can be used to sustain the body way more than certain plants, green beans, corn.
Gotcha.
Numerous vegetables.
1620.
Numerous vegetables that you put in your body. Marijuana has more substance.
I got you. So, is that the only thing that you feel as though can heal you?
No, absolutely not. I can make no argument to say that all plants that are put here are edible. If you use
for the
correct purpose, if you misuse, yes.
Right.
Then
I got you.
I am
using
for that.
Right. Okay, so I'm glad you made that distinction. So, if as long as you're not abusing that, yes. And as long as you're not using that to get high, it's for your medical purpose. But you got to understand that's between you and the Most High God as to whether you use that or not. Because we're going to show you the scripture where it says you're defiling your temple. Because the Most High God, he makes everything plain, right? And I'm going to show you another scripture that he made very plain. Read what you got.
This is the book of Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 16 and verse 12. For it was neither herb nor mollifying plaster.
Read that first part again.
The book of Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 16 and verse 12. For it was neither herb nor mollifying plaster that restored them to health.
You see that? The Most High God says it was neither herb nor mollifying plaster that would restore. So you got to believe on the Most High God, bro, and trust that he's going to restore you to your health if you obey in his law, statutes, and commandments. Right?
I do.
You congregate.
I pray to God to send me some.
You still smoke weed? For what purpose?
For my selfish purpose.
For your selfish purpose?
Wait a minute.
You still smoke weed? For what purpose?
For my selfish purpose.
for yourself is first. So you know you got to cut that out, right?
Bring it out.
So why even bring up the health thing?
Bring it out. Smoke
for a selfish purpose.
Bring it out.
Right. I hear you. But why even tie that to yourself? If you know that you do it for a selfish purpose.
That's my personal.
And you know, we just showed you how you should defy your temper, so you know you gotta stop, right? Hey, we are, like I said, we out here showing our brothers these scriptures. I feel you. But hey, it's not me talking though. It's not me talking. This is the Most High God that's speaking to you.
What's your name, bro? Sermon. My name's Elkanah. Good to meet you, brother. So, what's your purpose of smoking weed?
Personal
preference. Right. So, go to Proverbs 3 and 5 real quick. So, what we got to understand, hold on, let me bring this out real quick. I'm going to let you speak, brother. Just let me bring this out real quick. But we're not doing it as hypocrites. We are set up as judges of the Lord to bring his people in order. We're not going to tell you not to do something, and we're the ones doing it. We're not up here as hypocrites, brother. We're teaching you according to the word of God. Give what you got.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 3 and verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thine own understanding.
This is what we can't do, brother. We can't lean onto our own understanding. You want to get to the kingdom of heaven? No, I asked that question. No man knows whether or not we're going to get to the kingdom, brother.
Right.
Why are you walking away, bro? I'm dealing with you. I'm dealing with you. This is Rock 32:17. You won't walk away, bro. You don't want to deal with your brothers now.
I don't want to
deal. I ain't even brought nothing out yet.
Listen to me.
Look, this is the thing. As a brother that look, would you tell your father, hey, don't correct me, nigga. You in sin too. You can't tell me nothing. Would you tell your father that?
My dad stays with me. I tell
but would you tell him that? If your dad, but your response would be, you can't tell me nothing, dad, because you do things wrong too. Would that be wisdom?
Yes.
No, it's not wisdom, bro. We all need somebody to guide us the right way. If the reason why you don't want to hear this man, bro, because of this scripture right here. Read what you got.
The book of Sirach, chapter 32, and verse 17. A sinful man.
A what?
A sinful man will not be reproved.
A sinful man will not be reproved. The difference between you and us, when we're in our sin and somebody tells us about it, we correct the sin.
That's
we correct the sin. We don't make excuses for our sin. Do what you got.
A sinful man will not be reproved.
A sinful man will not be reproved. And this is what leaning on your own understanding will do to you.
Right.
This is what leaning on to your own understanding will do to a brother. When you don't get reproved correctly according to the word of God.
That's your brother.
When you go off your own understanding. Hey, is that why you don't congregate, brother? Because you don't want to be corrected? That's what individual lives do, bro. And it's a commandment to congregate so you can get corrected and get your life right.
That's right.
Not make excuses for your sin.
Right.
You cannot, smoke weed and think you're going to get to the kingdom of heaven.
Right.
You're defiling your temple according to the Bible.
That's right.
Read what you got.
A sinful man will not be reproved, but find it an excuse according to his will.
He'll do what?
Find it an excuse.
Oh, it's for medical purposes. I do it sometimes. I do it for my own preference. It makes me feel good.
But find it an excuse.
He'll find an excuse. What Brother Solin was doing was bringing excuses of why he defiles his temper as a repenting Israelite.
Right.
He's making up excuses. When you come to serve God, the true God of Israel, God don't want to hear your excuses.
That's right.
God wants you to repent and show by your actions that you love him.
That's right.
You're not giving up excuses of why you sin. Change your ways.
Right.
A sinful man will not be reproved, but find it an excuse according to his will.
According to his will. I said, brother, Why do you smoke weed? Oh, it's a personal preference. Don't judge me. Don't point your finger at me. So this brother fulfilled this scripture here, being a simple man, not wanting to be reproved, making excuses for his sin. We as a people need to change our ways. We need to quit making excuses for our sins and change by actions of listening to the word of God.
That's right.
We got to put away our own. Give me Proverbs 14 and 12. Proverbs 14 and 12. We can't lean on our own understanding. When that day comes, when the black Messiah cracks the sky and the day of judgment comes, you can't give a bunch of excuses of why you didn't follow God's commandments.
Right.
God is not listening to your excuses.
Right.
Read.
So book of Proverbs chapter 14 and verse 12. There is a way which seemeth right unto a man.
There is a way that seemeth right unto a man. A brother Solomon says, hey, I saw you brothers. I'm learning that I'm an Israelite. I'm following the Torah. I'm trying to keep the laws and commandments. The brother didn't have fringes on his clothes. And the brother don't keep the Sabbath day to congregate with a body. And he had no beard. He's shaving his beard. So there's a way that seemeth right unto a man. You think you're serving God the right way, but you're not. You're serving God according to your own ways and according to your own lust.
That's right.
And giving excuses when the Bible tells you to change, you give an excuse of why you don't change.
Right.
Read.
There is a way which seemeth right unto a man.
I smoke weed because it's my preference.
But the end thereof are the ways of death.
What's the end result?
The end thereof are the ways of death.
The end thereof are the ways of death. That's why we are out here, to give you warning from death that's coming to here.
Right.
Coming to the world. Judgment coming to the world. That's why we are out here, to give you warning from death, because we want to save your souls.
That's right.
That's why we show you the right way that God has commanded you to serve him.
Hello.
Not according to your own ways. God has a specific way we must walk in order to get into the kingdom of heaven. There's no excuses for you not to follow these laws and commandments.
Right.
Give me Jeremiah 4 and 22. I'm going to give it back to you, soldier. Jeremiah 4 and 22. So we need to quit making excuses, quit smoking weed, quit doing drugs, defiling our temples, and not walking around here sober-minded. That's a commandment, to be sober-minded. There's neither herb nor mollifying plaster that will heal you, but the word of God is what heals you. So if you give an excuse of, I do drugs to feel better about my life, if you give an excuse of, I smoke crack because it makes me feel better and it relieves stress, that is a sin. You're making an excuse according to your sin.
That's right.
God said his word will heal you. That's what heals you. That's what changes your mind. That's what gives you comfort. That's what strengthens your spirit. To walk uprightly.
That's right.
But our people want to make excuses of why they sin. Read.
It's the book of Jeremiah, chapter 4, verse 22.
Bring it out.
For my people is foolish. They have not known me.
God's people are foolish. They have not known him. Hey, sister. Hey, sister right there on the phone. With all their beautiful children. Sis. According to the Bible, the blacks, Hispanics, and natives are the biblical Israelite, and we must repent and keep God's commandments in these last days.
That's right.
I'm just going over. We make excuses not to follow God's commandment. How will we know what commandments we must keep if you don't stop and listen to the prophets of God telling you what commandments you must keep?
That's right. Oh.
You don't know that the women ain't supposed to be wearing pants?
Bring it out!
You don't know that the women's supposed to be dressing in modest apparel?
They're
walking around like whores! Dressed like whores! Our sisters don't know these things! Do you not know you can't smoke weed in order to elevate your mind? You're not supposed to do these things! How would you know? How would you know if you don't come up and listen to the Bible?
That's right!
The reason why you don't listen to the Bible, because you want to make excuses for your sins and you don't want to be corrected with God's words. We're not bringing our own words, we're bringing thus saith the Lord.
That's right.
Read what you got.
So book of Jeremiah, chapter 4, verse 22. For my people is foolish, they have not known me.
God's people are foolish. For you to think you can smoke weed and enter into the kingdom of heaven is a foolish thought.
Right.
For you to think you can serve God and wear an underwear in public is a foolish thought.
Right.
You have not known God. The reason why you don't know God, because you don't know who you are, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. You don't know that you are the biblical Israelites according to the Bible. And you don't know what God requires of us as his chosen people.
They are sottish children.
We are sottish, stupid children. We don't follow God's words. We don't listen to the Bible. Look what you got right there. That's fine, keep your money. We're not out here for money, man.
I don't care.
We're not going to accept your money out here. If you want to donate, check this out. What's your name?
John,
my name's Elkanah.
I know the Lord.
We're not accepting your money out here, John. You're going to leave your money. That money's going to stay right here on the ground if you drop that money. We're not accepting. We teach the gospel for free.
Yes, sir.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.